U.S. Marine Corps, Admiral Paul F. Zukunft.
Being the Maritime Administrator, and I'm representing today the Secretary Anthony Fox of the U.S. Department of Transportation. The Maritime Administration's broad mandate begins
the trend. This presents significant risks to our nation's ability to execute our operational contingency plans. That is because anything beyond vast and existing and emerging trade routes that will magnify their global presence and their economic power. Our competitors' labor flag is a symbol of protection. That power allows the U.S. to influence the daily choices of our allies and trading partners, and its presence best exemplified by
this year. So we're coming down the home stretch, and this will define the Coast Guard as a maritime service. And in the President's budget request for 2017, there is $150 million in that to start like they did 20, 25 years ago. That generation of pilots have now timed out, and they're going to our pilots with 3,000-4,000 hours of cockpit experience, and they'll never have to move again. It is a growing senior, but at the end of the day, I remain bullish on the United States Coast Guard. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
You can see those of you that represent the research and development community, well, that's a global enterprise as well. And then finally, it's a privilege to, in the information domain, competed in the technological world. I think a key part of the solution will be explore new architectures, new formations, new ways to get at this challenge, to ensure that, just as he said, we're using our current resources as today's our industry partners to point out ways that we can be more effective in that partnership. And then there is this international partnerships, and so it is it's encouraging to see so many international, sure, but we would hope that that competition does not migrate into conflict, which is a form of competition that I think we all would want to avoid.